Do you want to let more visitors to your Shopify store know about your offers and sales? In this video, you'll learn how to make an announcement bar for Shopify to boost your sales. Once in the Optin Monster dashboard, we click the green Create Campaign button, and we're going to choose the floating bar option to create our announcement bar. As you can see, Optin Monster has a variety of templates. In our case, we're going to choose the tiles template. Then all we have to do is name our campaign. We'll call this one Shopify Announcement. Choose your Shopify store in the dropdown and start building. The template will automatically load in the builder. And the first thing we are going to change is the message. All you have to do is click over the text and type in the new text. Here we'll say get 50% off women's sportswear today. Make sure to save your changes throughout the process as you build your opt-in form. You can decide to have your floating bar display on the top or the bottom of the page by simply toggling where it says load floating bar at top of page to on. Since we're announcing a sale, we don't necessarily need the email field. So we'll go to the yes, no buttons and toggle it to on. When we disable the no button, we can create a shop now button that drives even more traffic to our offer. So in the yes text, we put shop now and we scroll down to the no field and toggle it to off. Next, we want to make sure our shop now button redirects our website visitor to the page URL where our offer is placed. So the yes action will be redirect to a new page and we'll add the URL of the product category where you have the sale. Next, we'll go to display rules to determine when the announcement bar will appear. Where it says when the campaign should appear, we'll type in 0 seconds so that our announcement bar will be present on our site at all times. As you can see here, you can also determine for your announcement bar to show on specific collections, articles, or Shopify pages. If you're repeating an offer you displayed in a pop-up, you can make sure your visitors only see your announcement bar if they close that specific pop-up with on-site follow-up campaigns. Next, all we have to do is click Publish and toggle from paused to live. If you have not yet integrated your Shopify store with Optin Monster, please see our video on how to do so. If you want to use the Shopify announcement bar to drive email subscriptions, then stick with the default campaign with the email field. To create urgency for your sales and offers, you can also choose a countdown timer template. Once in the opt-in field, you go to the countdown settings, and you can decide between a static or a dynamic countdown timer. Dynamic countdown timers allow the countdown timer to adjust to each individual visitor, while the static countdown timer has a fixed universal end time and date for all website visitors. Another option is to use both the yes/no buttons to send people to different offers depending on the choice they make. In this instance, the yes button will redirect to women's wear, while the no button will redirect to men's wear. This is an excellent method to encourage your website visitors to shop and browse through the offers on your site. If you have any questions, please look through our helpful documentation. And for further assistance, you can always submit a support ticket and we'll be more than happy to help.